lot better than she was. She wasn't doing this well in the beginning. Good girl. So that's great. So she's starting to find comfort in what I ask her. Open the hips. Move the hips around the shoulder more, like that. And back her up. Good. This is good for her lower back and the lower head. Good girl. Don't put them there. Good. And again, I'm going to open her hips the other way. Keep her shoulders near me still. This is just a warm up. Good. So that she can find her legs good. Back. Good. This helps the horse find her four corners. Good. I want her to do it with a little more energy. A little more zest. Good. I'm going to share his hands. Good girl. Good. The repetition helps the horse to unlock them. Good. Make her walk forward as soon as she hits the rail. Good. Back. Good. Over. Good. Now she's starting to take this right hind under the belly and cross better, which is a big issue in the beginning. Good. She wasn't convinced that she should use that hind. It wasn't rehabbed correctly, I don't believe, when she had that injury. And when she was started under saddle, she did well enough, but she didn't feel good girl. Now I'm going to try to move the shoulders around the hips. Good girl. Very good. Very good. Huh? Very good. I'm going to line her up to do it now in the other direction. I like to put the horse on the rail to start that. Good. Super straight. Okay. Good. So we were having problems yesterday with the shoulders coming around from the left. So I just need to get after it a little bit more. That's the issue she needs. Resolve. Good. Understand, move her left shoulder around and sit on the right hind. Again, it's because of the right hind. Good. But the left shoulder is having an issue. Diagonal pair, good. Finding the right timing to help assist her. Make sure I'm not in front of those legs if she strikes, because she is, after all, an Andalusian. Good. Wow. She did a full turn that time. Very good. Good, much better. So we're going to keep working on this left shoulder. Good. Up, up, up. This horse should have had a lot of work in hand on the ground with a bridle and saddle before she was ridden. And she should have been explaining these ABCs. Good. So here I'm just letting her go from one side to the other. She's picking the jaw. And sometimes when they got loose enough, sure, that's it. So there, the chest is opening in here. You can see right in the front here, the chest is opening. And the horse is trying to step through with her right hind. Good. And I'm petting her with the whip, stroking down the thigh. Tell her I want her put in some rearing, reaping, and avoid the stand. Stated it was. That would be also a good reason not to want to use the balance correctly into the right floor and stretch the right floor open. But now my job, since she was adjusted, is to say, hey, it doesn't hurt anymore. See? And of course we use the MagnaWave to help reduce any inflammation and pain and promote healing. Good. Now I'm going to turn her. I'm not letting her make a big circle and get carried away. I want her to get the balance. I want her to employ this right hind and the hind legs more correctly and opening the chest. So I'm using these smaller figure eights to keep the steam engine from happening and to encourage that hind leg like that. Good girl. I have to be careful. She could kick me if I was rude with my whip. I try not to be rude. I try to give the pressure the horse needs, no more. And I increase it if I need more. Good, there I think she's trying to balance, so I'm letting her play. Between the jingle of my lunge catechism and the jingle of the tip of my whip, good. She gets that the balance is right there. Very nice, Lady Z, good girl. And try going left, which is much more difficult. That's where they mired her up the worst. The side ring, because she was already stuck from the injury. There, I tapped at the croup and touched her under more. Inside hind, do it a better share. There, now we can see there she's taking the weight off the inside shoulder. And she's bringing it to the right hind. Good girl. And she's still not quite sure she wants to put all that weight on the right hind. Little hesitation in that striding and how much she uses that right hind. And my job is going to be to keep quietly encouraging it there, there, good, to step down on it with confidence. So she learns it's a good thing, it's not bad. Good. An unbalanced shoulder, he chose to walk. Good. Good. Very nice, Nazarena. Very nice, Lady. Good girl. So today she's choosing to work with me. Yesterday she was more panicky about her body, so I'm going to expand the circle. I want to see about all her gates. Not that I feel she's ready for all the gates, but it's more of a test to see where she's at. Let me see if I can expand the circle so she can use her base better and more easily. Smaller circles test balance more. Bigger circles help the horse make it easier. It's less restrictive. So right off. So I didn't ask if I can. At the trot, you really want to get this haunch to come under a bit more. There. Like that. Good. Steps under. So in my encouraging of the hind leg, I have to half hold front. Good. Like that. So a little bit shoulder in, first stride or two, then I release the neck. So she finds it and wiggles her shoulders loose. Good. Finding her position. Good girl. this horse is supposed to roar. And it's very humid here today. We have a nice breeze off the ocean. We're supposed to have storms, which didn't come to fruition. We do need the water desperately.